More than 30,000 votes were cast in that last round, and we have a top four. Good afternoon. I am Nick Novak, Vice President of Communications and Marketing at Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce. Welcome to our final show of the 2022 Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin contest, where we are going to announce our top four products who are going to be competing for that top title. Before we go into announce the top four who are moving on in this contest, we do have some fun things that we're going to do, including unveiling the trophy that the winner gets to take home next week. Each and every year, WMC partners with EK in Fall River, Wisconsin, to manufacture a custom trophy for the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin winner. And in addition to EK, we also have EFCO Finishing that really puts just a great finish on this trophy. We absolutely love the work that they do at EK and are glad that we've been able to partner with them for the last 7 years on this manufacturing of the trophy. And so with that, we are going to unveil the trophy for the winner that we will announce next week. So let's take a look at it. Wow, really just an amazing product that EK makes each and every year. As I said, we could not be prouder to work with them on this trophy. It is just an awesome product, all steel, welded together, and then EFCO does a great job of putting that finish on it. So I know the winner of the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin will be proud to display this in their facility for years to come. So a huge thank you to EK and EFCO Finishing for once again manufacturing the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin trophy. I also want to say a huge thank you to Johnson Financial Group. As we've talked about in the past, they're our supporter for this contest, and we couldn't be prouder to work with them as well each and every year. I was actually fortunate enough to have a conversation with Jim Popp, the CEO of Johnson Financial Group, earlier this week to talk about why they get involved with the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin each year and everything that they do to help support the manufacturing industry. So let's go ahead and take a look at that interview earlier this week. Well, Jim, thank you so much for joining us today to talk a little bit about the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin contest. This is the 7th year that WMC has participated with Johnson Financial Group on the Coolest Thing. So, you know, just looking back, what are some of the things that excite you most about this contest?
You know, Nick, number one, thanks for having us back again this year. I can't believe it's been 7 years. It's been a lot of fun. I think the exciting thing about the contest for us has been the breadth and depth and diversity of products that are made in the state of Wisconsin and being able to highlight some of those and kind of show those that don't see them on a regular basis like you and I do what goes on in the state. That's been a lot of fun.
Well, now I think a lot of people in Wisconsin, they know the Johnson name, they know Johnson Financial Group, and especially anyone who follows along this contest, they know a little bit about Johnson Financial Group. But could you just tell me a little bit more about what your team does and how you serve your clients?
Sure. Well, you know, as a company, we're proud to have been in the state of Wisconsin for the last 52 years. We're celebrating 52 years this year. And, you know, what started as a double wide trailer on a corner in Racine has turned into a full service bank in the commercial and retail and consumer and private business, among others, a full service mortgage company, a wealth and investment advisory business, and an insurance agency, all wrapped into one privately held, locally owned family business, which we're real proud of.
Well, we're proud of the fact that you guys continue to do this contest with us each year. As I have mentioned many times, not only is Johnson Financial Group a huge supporter of this contest, you guys really do help support the manufacturing industry here in Wisconsin, and so thank you for that. Speaking of manufacturing, it's Manufacturing Month. We are celebrating the entire month of October, our state's largest industry. And so what does it mean to you and your team at Johnson Financial Group to be involved in the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin each and every year?
Well, like I said earlier, I think what it means to us is it means that we're celebrating a huge part of the economy in this state. You know, manufacturing is kind of the lifeblood of what Wisconsin is, and it creates jobs, it creates vocations, it creates so much in the state of Wisconsin that is valuable to all of us as citizens in the state of Wisconsin. So it's great for us to be involved in it. We love it.
Now, I mentioned this a few weeks ago. Our first round of voting actually helped us to surpass 1 million total votes in the crazy. Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin contest. Yeah, amazing. I mean, it's just a crazy feat that we've gotten to. Did you ever think that this contest would take off the way it did or become as popular as it did?
If I wanted to sound smart, I would say yes, I knew that would happen. But honestly, no, I did not think that would be the case. But I think it's surpassed most people's expectations and in a really good way. And it just goes to show that when you do it the right way and when you showcase the kinds of companies you're showcasing, people are interested in it. It's compelling and it's interesting. So that's great.
Well, as I mentioned, you know, excited that we're able to partner with you guys each and every year on this. Last question before we do wrap up here. I'm not going to make you divulge who you've been voting for once per day per device, as everyone else is doing here at WMC and throughout the state of Wisconsin. But any surprises over the last 7 years by products that were entered or any winners? You know, anything that surprised you in that time frame?
I'm not going to say surprising. I would say pleasantly pleased with it. And that is, even if you look at, I was just looking online at the final 16 today. What a cool bunch of companies! What a diverse bunch of companies, from a company that makes plates to fire engines to, I mean, what a diversity of companies from size, from scale, from breadth of what they do. That's been probably the biggest pleasant surprise that we've had is to see all those things in the state of Wisconsin.
That's definitely been a fun thing for me to kind of take a look at each and every year we do this because, the manufacturing industry in Wisconsin truly is diverse. We make so many cool things. So, Jim, thank you for joining us today, and a huge thanks to Johnson Financial Group for once again partnering with us on this contest.
You bet, Nick. Thanks for having us again.
Well, thanks again to Jim Popp for sitting down with me earlier this week and talking a little bit about their involvement in this contest. As I said, a huge thank you to Johnson Financial Group for all that they do for WMC, this contest, and the manufacturing industry. Now we are going to get to the top four products who are our finalists competing to be named the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. A total of 119,000 votes have been cast in this contest already, and we're going to get more added to that number in this next round, in which voting starts tomorrow. So let's go ahead and let's take a look at what four products will be competing to be named the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. In our first matchup, we had Pierce Manufacturing going up against Jolly Good Soda. An interesting combo right there, obviously. Food processing going up against a large vehicle manufacturer. And our winner by 6,400 votes to just over 4,300 votes is Pierce Manufacturing from Appleton, Wisconsin, with their electric fire truck. We've talked a lot about this product. They have been getting a lot of votes each and every round. Definitely could be a favorite going into this final round of voting. So congratulations to Pierce Manufacturing and their electric fire truck for moving on to the final round and hopefully, vying to be the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. Moving on to our next matchup, we had ETC in Middleton going up against H&S Manufacturing. This one was a very tight race. Just a few hundred votes separated the two products as we got down to the wire here. But winning this contest with 3,896 votes is H&S Manufacturing with their Loadmaster 2X. This is a fantastic product for for our farmers here in Wisconsin, really allowing them to more efficiently collect everything from those farm fields, get it transported onto a trailer and hauled off by a truck to wherever that product needs to go. This is actually an upset. H&S is a number 7 seed going up against ETC out of Middleton with that number 2 seed. So congratulations to H&S, nearly 4,000 votes in this last round. They will be going on to compete to be named the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. Going down to our next matchup in the bracket, Plexus Corporation going up against Aaron's with that Mammoth 850. Aaron's a number 11 seed coming into this, so definitely an uphill battle, and unfortunately just couldn't get enough to get over the hump into that final round. So Plexus Corp with their Quidel Savannah testing system. Now this allows folks in doctor's offices and anywhere else that you need rapid testing for RSV, for the flu, and of course, COVID-19. This is a fantastic product that Plexus is making, and they are moving on to that next round. 3,595 total votes is what Plexus got in this last round, so quite a few, and just enough to bump them into our top 4. Congratulations to the entire team at Plexus for being one of our finalists. And now the last matchup. We have one more product that is going to move into our top 4, competing to be named the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. Fincantieri Bay Shipbuilding going up against Columbia Vehicle Group. This was actually, I think, our closest matchup in our top 8, 3,456 votes to 3,148 votes. So just a couple hundred vote difference over the last week. And Columbia Vehicle Group will be moving on to the top 4. Congratulations to the team there with their Tomberlin Emerge Beachcomber, this electric golf cart style vehicle that they manufacture in Reedsburg. Really fun to see them making it into the top 4. Fincantieri has competed numerous times in the coolest thing made in Wisconsin, and unfortunately not enough to make it into the top 4 this time around. But so many amazing products have been involved in the contest so far. Around 130 of them started off. We had roughly 130 nominees that came in throughout the month of August for this, and we are now down to our 4 finalists who are vying to be named the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. We will announce the winner on October 19th. That is 1 week from today. And that is after our final round of voting. We're back to a popular vote, so no more head-to-head matchups. These 4 products will be competing to get as many votes as they can from you to hopefully be named that coolest thing made in Wisconsin. Voting will start tomorrow, so Thursday morning at 8 a.m. You can go to madeinwis.com and start casting your votes for what you think is the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. What you can do is vote once per day, per device. So go to madeinwis.com on your computer, on your cell phone, on your tablet. Vote as many times as you can and with your different devices, but just once per day, per device. And if you have a favorite, make sure you're getting out the vote. Talk to your friends, talk to your colleagues, talk to your family. Talk about why you think this product is so cool and why they should be able to take home the trophy that is sitting right next to me. So we'll announce the winner October 19th at WMC's Business Day in Madison event. If you're still looking to see who the winner is live, you can register for Business Day by going to WMC.org. There's a button right on the homepage where you can register for this event. Not only are we announcing the winner of the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin contest, we have some great speakers who will be participating in this event. Troy Link, CEO of Jack Links, will be doing a fireside chat with our CEO, Kurt Bauer. We'll have some candidates who are running for office, from Tim Michaels to Eric Toney. We will have a lot of other great speakers, and we certainly hope that you will be joining us at Business Day on October 19th as we unveil the winner. Once again, a huge thank you to Johnson Financial Group for partnering with us on this contest. Each and every year, this is our our seventh year of doing the contest, and Johnson Financial Group has been there every step of the way. So thank you to them for all of their support. And thank you to EK and EFCO Finishing for producing this amazing trophy that is sitting right next to me. We will be giving that to our winner in just 7 days. And finally, do not forget to vote each and every day. You can start voting tomorrow at 8 a.m. at madeinwisc.com. And voting will be open until Wednesday, October 19th at noon. So if you're joining us at Business Day, you'll still be able to vote while you're there, and we will announce the winner just after lunch at that Business Day event. So congratulations to all of our finalists. Congratulations to all of our nominees who participated this year. And don't forget to start voting tomorrow. And then we will see you at Business Day in Madison 1 week from today. Thank you.